Hi and welcome to this video about setting up a job site. As a construction surveyor, you're responsible for setting up the job site to ensure that the crew can work safely, efficiently and according to time plan. Understanding the procedures on a job site is vital when setting it up. Anders Forsell, what is important to consider as a construction surveyor when you're setting up a job site?
Well, first of all, you need to think about what technology you want to use and also what circumstances you have. I mean, the characteristics and the environment on the site. Whether it's suitable for GNSS or if it should be a total station work to be done.
Then let's start looking at the GNSS. What is important to consider in that regard?
Yeah, well, GNSS, that's the Global Navigation Satellite System. So we need to have sky visibility. So it has to be open space. And that's number one. Then you also need to have a communication between your base station and your machine. The base station, that is the GNSS receiver you put up on a known point that will send correction information to the machine, making sure that the machine gets a centimeter accuracy. So to have a good either radio or Wi-Fi or any other technology to transmit this correction data, that is very vital.
And that is a surveyor task to set all those things up?
Yeah, it is. Of course, it's also up to site management what they want to do, but in general, it is a surveyor that will take the responsibility for making it work, also after establishment and after setup.
How about coordinate systems?
Well, the coordinate system is, of course, also a mandatory thing with when working with GNSS. So to use the correct coordinate system for that particular site or that particular area is, of course, vital for the position accuracy. And of course, also when the machines are connected, and you got the fixed solution in the machine, you need to verify that your coordinates on your tool point on the, let's say, bucket or blade is actually corresponding to the real coordinates where you are.
Let's talk a little bit about the GNSS again. So you have the GNSS antennas on a machine, then we have a base station. How does the communication between them work? Because I know we have an excavator here and we have a base station on site as well. Could you please describe the interaction between those two?
Yep. The base station is set up and is basically storing the point where it's at. It's comparing those coordinates that it calculates from the satellites with the known coordinates of where its position is. The distance between the base station and the satellites is very similar to the distance between the satellites and the machine. So the impact and the influence on geographic we call atmospheric effects or impacts is the same in both the base and the machine. So the correction that the base is calculating when comparing its calculated position with its known position, that correction information is similar in the machine. And it's calculated in the base station and then it's transmitted to the machine where it's recalculating the machine position.
And what is important for the position of the base station compared to the machine? Should they be able to see each other, or how does that work?
There's no requirement for a line of sight between the base station and the machine. But since they're both using satellites, of course, both the machine and the base station need to have sky visibility. The more satellites you have, the better it is. The base station is crucial because when you set that up, you should always put it up on a location where it's very, very open and clear sky, so no obstructions at all nearby. Because where the machine is going to work, you can't really always impact on the environment, because it might be that the machine or your rover as a surveyor, that you need to be close to a forest or you need to be close to a building that will limit your sky visibility. And in that case, the limitation should only be in one end of the system. So the base should always be able to receive as many satellites as possible, since the machine might be impacted by obstruction and get limited numbers of satellites. But since we are calculating the correction on the satellites that are in common between the base and the machine, it's important to have as much visibility as possible.
And that's actually a very good point, that it's very crucial that to understand that it has to be the same satellites that both the base station and the machine uses in order to work.
Correct.
So Anders, what can you tell about accuracy? Because how accurate is the system with a GNSS and a base station?
The accuracy is depending on the distance between the rover and the base station. So the further away you are from the base, the weaker or the more inaccurate will your position be. But if you are within a couple of kilometers from the base, then you will have, let's say, 2 to 3 centimeters of accuracy. So it's okay for, let's say, non-precise work. You maybe shouldn't do sewage close to a curbstone. You don't do the final asphalt pavement with GPS or GNSS, for example, because the fluctuation is a little bit too big for that. Mm. But ordinary earth-moving tasks, that's absolutely perfect for GNSS, because it's also a kind of a computer. Mm. So it's very easy for the operator. He will turn it on in the morning. When everything is set in the background, it will remember the settings from the day before. And when you are you get the connection with the satellites, you get the connection with the base station, you will get a fixed solution in your machine, then you're ready to go. Nothing additional to be done.
Sometimes you are in an area with limited visibility to the sky, or if you need a higher accuracy, in these cases you can use a total station. Anders, what should we consider as a construction surveyor when working with a total station?
Well, first of all, the total station is an optical and mechanical instrument. So it's very, very sensitive to vibrations. It will require line of sight between the instrument and the machine. And it will also require radio communication or Bluetooth communication, as we do on our solutions. Mm-hmm. So since it's a high precision tool, it also needs to be calibrated once in a while. So it's very, very important to keep the maintenance of the instrument.
And what should you consider when setting it up on the job site? Mm-hmm. How is that procedure?
Well, the procedure to set up is that you do a resection, as mm-hmm. you do with any total station, even if you're a surveyor doing ordinary survey stakeout work. Mm-hmm. So you do a resection to known points, and after that you do the calculation, of course. You will get the accuracy of your station setup. You are establishing radio communication or Bluetooth communication to the machine, mm-hmm. because there will be a Bluetooth radio modem inside the machine communicating instead of your rover. Mm-hmm. And then you aim towards the prism on the machine, and basically the position of your total station is getting transferred into the machine control panel. Mm-hmm. And then you do the rest of the control from the panel in the machine. So everything you as a surveyor can do on a rover pole, controlling, steering the instrument and so on, will be done from the panel in the machine. Mm.
And here we can see the distance between the total station and the machine is of course very small. What is the ideal range for a total station and a machine?
Well, for the setup and the work range, mm-hmm. I wouldn't recommend more than 150 meters in a radius. So theoretically, if the machine is passing by the station from one end to another, you could cover roughly up to 300 meters as a total driving distance for the machine. Mm-hmm. I wouldn't put the station closer than 15 or 20 meters to the machine, because the closer to the machine you come, the higher speed the turn on the instrument needs to have, because the instrument is tracking the prism all the time. So as long as there can be a nice and smooth tracking, we can do the measurement with it both, distance-wise and the angle-wise, then you will also have a smooth operation. But the impact will also be, let's say, weather and wind. So if it's foggy or if it's raining, mm-hmm. it can be a bit tricky. The same is also if it's very hot, because it's very, very sensitive to refractions from the ground. Mm-hmm. So to set up a total station on a higher position, so you basically almost like view from a top-down perspective mm-hmm. to the machine, that is quite often beneficial. Mm. Also, since maybe you've got trucks or other machinery coming between in the line of sight, that is also, of course, important to think about and take that into consideration when they put the station up.
How many targets would you suggest or would you propose to measure with the total station when setting it up?
As a let's say, for backsides, so for the resection, I would recommend 3 mm-hmm. at least. You can do it with 2, but I wouldn't really trust that value. So 3 is my strongest recommendation.
So of course the different total station varies a little bit, but can you tell anything in general on how you should perform setting it up? Is there anything you should consider while doing that?
Yeah, first of all, not all total stations can actually run with machine control. So first of all, you need to verify that it's suitable for machine control. Usually it's a license, but that license also comes together with some of the mechanics inside. Secondly, how the radio communication or the Bluetooth communication is set up, that varies a bit from instrument to instrument. But in most cases, you start with a resection, and after that, you do the calculation of the resection to get your position. Mm. After that, there's usually a couple of button pushes to, let's say, start the communication with an external third-party device. Mm. And for Bluetooth, for example, it's usually together with a pairing, and you do one of the pairings from the instrument, and then, of course, it has to be paired to the radio in the machine. Mm. And when that pairing has been confirmed, you can check your control in the machine, because all the different, say, turning left, right, and so on can be done from the machine. And you will also see information from the instrument in the machine. Let's say, for example, station coordinates and also active live tracking values. Mm. So that is your confirmation that you're actually communicating with a correct total station.
And I'm guessing that once you've tried it a couple of times, it's pretty easy to set it up, since it's a standard procedure you just have to follow.
Yeah, it's not very often that operators do it themselves, but there are definitely operators that can be trained and skilled to do this themselves. Mm-hmm. But in the first couple of times, I would really suggest that it's a surveyor doing it, because it's all about, let's say, surveying skills to level the instrument and make sure that you measure to the right targets and so on. Mm-hmm.
Super, thank you very much, Anders. And that was basically it about setting up the job site, either you're using GNSS or if you're using a total station.